Every single day, another lie, another conspiracy theory, another racist dog whistle. Every day. It's like the Groundhog's Day for alternative realities. It is clear that this president will stop at nothing to try to win re-election, using everything at his disposal to achieve his goal. I'm going to walk you through this and tell you everything that he's doing. He is using the podium in the White House briefing room that you pay for to lie to you. And he is starting with birtherism. Can you believe it? Is it 2011 all over again? What is going on? Birtherism now against Kamala Harris, Joe Biden's vice presidential nominee, who is a black woman. Does that ring a bell to you? At his briefing, he was asked about a completely discredited op-ed in Newsweek questioning Harris's eligibility to be Joe Biden's running mate and questioning where she was born. And not surprisingly, it was retweeted by a lawyer for the Trump campaign.
So I just heard that, I heard it today, that she doesn't meet the requirements. And by the way, the lawyer that wrote that piece is a very highly qualified, very talented lawyer. I have no idea if that's right. I would have assumed the Democrats would have checked that out before she gets chosen to run for vice president. But that's a very serious. You're saying that they're saying that she doesn't qualify because she wasn't born in this country.
This man is so full of it, y'all. Come on. He knows better than that. He's a president of the United States. Shouldn't he have a modicum of decency and class and just say that, look, come on. Let's talk about something real. A lot of people have died from the coronavirus. That's serious. Kamala Harris is on the vice presidential ticket. Move along. No, he's got to go for these racist dog whistles. Birtherism, not even a dog whistle, birtherism. Again, people, I have a debate with myself about this every time one of these dumb, stupid conspiracy theory, QAnon, whatever it is. I have a debate with myself all the time as someone who is responsible for these hours right here on CNN for this platform. All the time, when faced with this ugliness and this disgusting sort of display from the president, do I want to use this time that I am given gratefully? I'm so grateful for it, to be able to talk to you, to amplify and allow this man and his apologists and minions to spread garbage like this? And the answer that I come up with is no. I don't. But then I ask myself, what is the alternative? Is it to let it go, let the ugliness go unchallenged, let more hate and more garbage seep into the seams that are barely holding this country together already? Should I give it light, or do I just ignore it because it's so ridiculous and that's exactly what they want? Is to elevate it so people are talking about it and therefore it becomes real if you say it enough, and then it taints and it stains someone in a way that they shouldn't be stained or tainted. It's a struggle. It really is. The struggle is real. I want you to know I don't repeat what this president said about this lightly. I hate to even read his tweets on the air because they are so ridiculous. I don't even follow him on Twitter anymore because his Twitter feed, what he puts out, is so toxic. It's just ridiculous. A white man questioning a black woman's birthplace in America in 2020. No other words but disgusting, racist, and purposely so. So, for the record, everyone, I'm going to say this once, don't know if I'm going to cover it again, but for the record, to get this out of the way, Kamala Harris was born in California, 1964, to immigrant parents. That's why he is planting this ugly question in people's minds, that she's a daughter of immigrants. Here's why it's even more disturbing. Same dirty racist tactic he used to try to derail Barack Obama.
I want him to show his birth certificate. Why? There's something on that birth certificate that he doesn't like.
People have birth certificates. He doesn't have a birth certificate. Now, he may have one, but there's something on that birth, maybe religion, maybe it says he's a Muslim. I don't know. And if he wasn't born in this country, which is a real possibility, I'm not saying it happened. I'm saying it's a real possibility.
A lot of people do not think it was an authentic certificate. Many people do not think it was authentic. His mother was not in the hospital. There were many other things that came out.
President Barack Obama was born in the United States, period.
So ridiculous, and you fell for it. And he always get whenever he asks a question, I don't know, or many people say, that is the clue. And as we know, Trump's already using misogynistic words against Harris, calling her nasty and mean, and then ramping up his attacks on her this morning in a TV interview. Here it is.
Now you have a sort of a mad woman. I call her, because she was so angry.
Mad woman. Okay, so here's, Kamala Harris is a member of the Senate, junior senator from California. Will any of her colleagues have the decency to stand up to Trump's birtherism attack against her? Will any of them? Surely, lawmakers, upstanding American lawmakers, would have the decency to stand up for her, right? Okay, so let me tell you this. My producers spent the evening reaching out to all 53 of Senator Kamala Harris's Republican colleagues in the Senate. Remember, they are co-workers right now. You know how many we heard back from? I'll let you guess at home. One. Senator John Kennedy of my home state of Louisiana. His team was polite, said that they hadn't heard about the story until we reached out. Didn't have anything to share. That's it. Hadn't heard about it, even though there was a press conference, was asked about it, right? Even if you hadn't heard, wouldn't you have a better answer than that? The other 52 didn't respond at all. Their silence speaks volumes. Their silence is complicit. But, you know, they are very busy right now not working on a coronavirus relief package now that the Senate has adjourned and Congress has gone home. They're so busy because, you know, they couldn't get back to say we're busy working for the American people.